Hi guys, how are you? Good morning, everyone. I hope everyone is fine and having a good time staying and studying at home. So today we are going to have a session on leadership theories. And in this particular session, I'll be covering a total of 11 leadership theories. So काफी ज़्यादा लंबा session होने वाला है. It might even last longer than 1 hour. So brace yourself for the session. काफी सारी थ्योरीज डिस्कस करेंगे, काफी नई थ्योरीज डिस्कस करेंगे. वी विल बी डिस्कसिंग अ लॉट ऑफ न्यू थ्योरीज. लेट मी सी हु ऑल आर हियर. हाय, गुड मॉर्निंग रोहन. गुड मॉर्निंग हिमानी. ओके, 21 स्टूडेंट्स ऑलरेडी कम. लेट मी वेट फॉर अ वाइल एंड देन वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द सेशन. लेट मी टेल यू व्हिच ऑल थ्योरीज आई विल बी कवरिंग टुडे. दैट विल गिव यू एन आइडिया कि ये सेशन आपके यूज का है भी या नहीं, वेदर दिस सेशन इज एक्चुअली गोइंग टू बी यूजफुल और नॉट. सो दीज आर द 11 थ्योरीज दैट आई विल बी कवरिंग टूडे. व्रूम येटोन जागो, डिसीजन मॉडल एल एम एक्स, फ्रेंच एंड रेवन्स फाइव फॉर्म्स ऑफ पावर, बास ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल थ्योरी, लीडरशिप पार्टिसिपेशन इन्वेंट्री, लिकर्ट सिस्टम, फोर स्टाइल्स ऑफ मैनेजमेंट बाय हैकमैन एंड हुनरी एजर, टेनेनबॉम एंड स्मिथ लीडरशिप स्टाइल कंटिन्यूम, गॉर्डन ऑलपोर्ट ट्रेड थ्योरी, एक्शन सेंटर्ड थ्योरी एंड 10 फेटल लीडरशिप फ्लॉज थ्योरी बाय जेंगर फोकमैन. ठीक है, सो दीज आर द 11 थ्योरीज दैट आई विल बी कवरिंग टुडे. भाई पीडीएफ मत मांगा करो, दैट इज द वर्स्ट फॉर्म ऑफ स्टार्टिंग दैट आई कैन हैव ऑफ एनी सेशन. I'm going to be spending more than an hour. You can easily write all this, and yet you want a PDF. जिसकी कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है. PDF ही चाहिए तो फिर PDF ही दे देते हैं. Why conduct these sessions? पढ़ाने का कोई फायदा ही नहीं है. If that is all you need, तो फिर session में आओ ही नहीं. It's not required. Okay, so you need to be very clear कि भाई live in the present. If you're having these sessions, I'm spending time more than an hour. आज सुबह 8 बजे से sessions are going on. 8 o'clock PIB, 9 o'clock RBI, and 10 o'clock this session is going on. No need, to actually look for PDFs. The sessions themselves are more than enough. ऐसे ही RBI वाले session में होता है, which is held at 9. People keep asking for PDFs, although those PDFs are not even relevant because they are just questions. और जो मैम बताती हैं, ऑल दोस थिंग्स आर एनीवेज नॉट अवेलेबल इन द पीडीएफ. ओके, आरबी 247, पीआईबी 247, स्पॉटलाइट मंथली सफिशिएंट फॉर सेबी ग्रेड ए फाइनेंशियल अवेयरनेस एंड करंट अफेयर्स. यस चिनमय, इट्स मोर देन इनफ. यू डोंट नीड एनीथिंग एल्स. उससे ज्यादा कोई कवर कर ही नहीं सकता है, बिकॉज आई एम कवरिंग आरबीआई वेबसाइट. मानसी मैम इज कवरिंग आरबीआई वेबसाइट ऑन डेली बेसिस. शी इज कवरिंग लाइव मिंट ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. स्पॉटलाइट में वी आर कवरिंग हिंदू, लाइव मिंट एंड ईटी ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. तो इससे ज्यादा न्यूज़पेपर और गवर्नमेंट सोर्सेज कोई कवर नहीं कर सकता है. पीआईबी में पीआईबी कवर कर रहे हैं रेगुलरली. ओके, 1% ओनली कवर्स पीआईबी ऑन अ डेली बेसिस. तो इससे ज्यादा कवरेज तो आई थिंक पॉसिबल ही नहीं है. इवन विजन 365 कवर्स लेसर देन दीज एरियाज. एंड द यूपीएससी मटीरियल तो थोड़ी चीजें होती हैं जो हिंदू में अवेलेबल होती हैं, विच आर रेलिवेंट फॉर यूपीएससी, विच आई मिस आउट, विच आई लीव डेलिबरेटली, बट दोज आर नॉट रिक्वायर्ड. यस ऑफ कोर्स अदिति, दिस इज रेलिवेंट फॉर आरबीआई, दिस इज रेलिवेंट फॉर सेबी, दिस इज रेलिवेंट फॉर यूजीसी नेट जेआरएफ आल्सो. लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स सिट हियर नाउअडेज हु आर फ्रॉम यूजीसी, हु आर राइटिंग यूजीसी नेट एग्जामिनेशन. फॉर देम आल्सो दिस इज रेलिवेंट. Yes, RBI Grade B also, Phase 1 and Phase 2, sufficient. PIB, RBI 247 and Spotlight. इससे ज़्यादा करने की कोई ज़रूरत नहीं है current affairs में. This is more than enough. You don't need anything else. चलो, let us start with the session. A lot of people have already entered. तो start करते हैं. If you have not subscribed to the channel, subscribe कर दो. Because I come online on a short notice whenever I feel that something important. Important has been covered by me. So subscribe karke bell icon dabaoge, it will be easier for you because you will get the notification immediately. Ek din advance mein notification mil jayega. It will be easier for you to organize your life. That's the only objective. Chalo, so let's start with the first one. The first one is Vroom Yeton Jago decision model. तो इसका एक चार्ट मैंने बनाया है खुद. सो दिस इज अ चार्ट दैट हैज बीन क्रिएटेड बाय मी. ऑल्दो द ब्रूम येट ऑन जागो मॉडल डज नॉट हैव अ चार्ट ऑफ इट्स ओन. इट वॉज क्रिएटेड बाय दीज थ्री पीपल, विक्टर व्रूम, फिलिप येटोन एंड आर्थर जागो. वॉट वॉज द एम ऑफ दिस मॉडल, पर्पज क्या था? टू आइडेंटिफाई द बेस्ट मैनेजमेंट स्टाइल दैट कैन बी अप्लाइड इन डिफरेंट सिचुएशन. तो देखो ये बहुत रिसेंट, इट्स अ वेरी रिसेंट मॉडल बिकॉज इट इज टेकिंग इन टू कंसिडरेशन दैट सिचुएशन हैव अ बिग रोल टू प्ले इन डिसाइडिंग वॉट काइंड ऑफ लीडरशिप स्टाइल और मैनेजमेंट स्टाइल शुड बी यूज बाय अ पर्सन इन अ पर्टिकुलर सिचुएशन. तो ये आइडेंटिफाई रियलाइज कर चुके थे when this theory came up that situations play a very big role. So situational leadership is the actual leadership. Okay, so objective yahi tha to identify the best management style that can be applied in a particular situation and subsequently the optimal decision making approach to implement in these situations. Matlab kya kya management style use karna hai different situations mein aur kis tarah se decision lena hai, kya decision making approach follow karni hai in different situations. That was the objective, which management style or leadership style to apply and how to take optimal decisions in different situations. So humne jo chart banaya, which is a graphical representation of this aim only, it says okay, there are different situations and when the situations are different then you need different methods of decision making, right? Situation alag alag hai, therefore you need to take follow different methods of taking decisions. You need to have different methods of taking decisions. Okay, Prabhakar, don't worry, whatever I'm speaking in Hindi, I'm saying the same thing in English also, so you don't need to worry about that. If you don't understand Hindi, it's not a problem. So I'm repeating myself in English wherever I use Hindi, so it should not be a problem at all. Don't get confused or don't think I'm using Hindi so I'm not relevant saying relevant stuff for you. Okay, so I was at this place where you have different situations, and because there are different situations, you need different methods of decision making. This is something that they assumed or took as granted. Now, how to take or make decisions in different situations? What method to be followed? There are three factors that, according to this theory, Vroom, Yeton, Jago decision model, there are three factors which need to be taken into consideration in order to make optimal decisions. So different situations hui sabse pehle. Ab alag alag situation mein alag tarike se decision lena hai. Different situations we need to take decisions in a different manner depending on the situation. What factors to keep in mind or take into consideration? The three factors are quality, team commitment or collaboration, and time. So Vroom said these three factors need to be kept into mind while taking decisions in different situations. And how do you measure level of impact of these three factors on the decision? Whether these three factors, quality, team commitment and time, were actually effective in taking the optimal decision. Optimal decision hua ya nahi hua, how to identify that? You measure it, and you measure it by answering 8 questions to determine influence of each factor. You answer 8 questions, we'll be talking about those 8 questions, and through those 8 questions you try to identify what was the influence of each factor on decision that was taken. And based on those 8 questions you make a decision tree to get the leadership style. So two things are here, decision making ho rahi hai and leadership style identify ho raha hai. Two things are happening. We are taking identifying the optimal decision method, and at the same time we are identifying the optimal leadership style as well. Okay, different situations, let's repeat. You have to take a decision based on a unique situation. You use three factors: quality, team commitment and time. We'll be talking about these one by one. Then what you do is you identify the level of impact of all these three factors on the decision, whether the decision was actually optimal or not. How do you do it? You create a decision tree, and through this decision tree then you come to the last process, last step in the process, which is to identify the optimal leadership style. There are 5 kinds of leadership styles here: AT1, AT2, CT1, CT2 and GT2. एक एक करके सारे कवर करेंगे, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. ओके, सो दिस इज वॉट ब्रूम येटोन जागो डिसीजन मॉडल इज ऑल अबाउट. नाउ लेट्स कम टू दीज थ्री फैक्टर्स. तो सबसे पहले समथिंग दैट वी नीड टू अंडरस्टैंड इज वॉट आर दीज थ्री फैक्टर्स एंड हाउ डू दे हेल्प अस इन ऑप्टिमाइजिंग और इन क्रिएटिंग टेकिंग ऑप्टिमल डिसीजन इन डिफरेंट सिचुएशन. तो वॉट आर दीज थ्री फैक्टर्स? क्वालिटी. क्वालिटी कहता है, क्वालिटी सेज दैट हायर क्वालिटी रिक्वायरमेंट मोर टाइम एंड टीम मेंबर्स टू बी इन्वॉल्व. क्वालिटी सेज इफ यू नीड द डिसीजन टू बी हायर इन क्वालिटी. देखो देर आर सर्टन डिसीजन विच आर वेरी ऑपरेशनल इन नेचर. लेट्स से आज कोई क्लाइंट आया है तो उसको कौन सा खाना खिलाना है, कौन सी पानी की बॉटल लानी है, विच काइंड ऑफ वाटर बॉटल डू यू नीड फॉर द क्लाइंट, वॉट काइंड ऑफ फूड डू यू वॉन्ट फॉर द क्लाइंट. दीज आर ऑल्सो डिसीजन एंड दीज आर वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट डिसीजन. आई रिमेंबर आई वॉज एन इंटर्न इन एन ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड देयर सम फॉरन डेलीगेट्स हैड कम, सम क्लाइंट्स हैड कम एंड बिस्लरीज वर सर्वड एज वाटर बॉटल्स एंड द सीईओ वॉज फ्यूरियस ऑन द एडमिन विच वॉज रिस्पॉन्सिबल फॉर टेकिंग केयर ऑफ ऑल दीज थिंग्स बिकॉज ही सेड दैट डोंट यू नो दैट वी ऑलवेज यूज कैच, वी नेवर यूज बिस्लरी बिकॉज बिस्लरी इज 20 रुपीज पर बॉटल, कैच इज 60-70 रुपीज पर बॉटल. ओके, सो हिमालयन एंड ऑल दोज वॉटर्स वर नॉट अवेलेबल देयर देन. सो इट्स अ रिप्रेजेंटेशन ऑफ द लेवल ऑफ योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, द स्टेटस ऑफ योर ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, वट काइंड ऑफ वॉटर आर यू यूजिंग एंड इट इज कंसिडर्ड वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट. ऑल्दो इट्स वेरी फेक बट इट्स कंसिडर्ड इंपॉर्टेंट. सो दिस इज अ वेरी वेरी crude, very small example of how important decision making can be at different levels in an organization. It can be a very small decision, it can be a very large decision. Okay, so with respect to your requirement of the quality of decision making, matlab kitna important task hai, what kind of quality do you need in the decision that is being taken, jitna zyada quality chahiye utna zyada analysis hoga. The more quality in the decision that you need, the more complex is the situation, the more time you need, the more team members are required, and that is only when you can ensure that the quality of the decision is higher. This is number one. Second is team commitment. Is this a one person decision or does it require collaboration? More team members means higher quality but more time required. Dekho, these three, quality, team commitment and time, they are directly correlated. More quality means requirement of more team commitment, means requirement of more time, and vice versa. More time required means more team commitment, means more quality. So if the decision can be taken through a one person, through one person only, then the team commitment required or collaboration, level of collaboration required is much less. If you need more team commitment, if the decision is difficult, is complex, is going to require more time, then more team members are going to be required and higher quality can be ensured only when you give more time. Okay, and third one is time. The more time available, the better decision can be taken and more team members can be a part of it. It is not about time that you want to give, but the time that you have in your hands. Okay, for a lot of decisions, you have only 5 minutes in your hands to decide. In a lot of decisions, you have only 10 seconds to decide. In a lot of decisions, you get days to decide what is to be done. Okay, so the more time you have, the more analysis you can carry out, the better decision can be, the more team members can be a part of it. Okay, so this is Vroom Yeton Jago decision model. Three factors from where we started, how to make decisions based on these three factors. Kitna quality chahiye, what kind of quality do you need in your decision? What kind of team commitment or what level of team commitment is required? And how much time do you have in your hands? Now, based on these three factors, you create a decision tree. Let me show you how a decision tree is created. So, aisa nahi hai, it's not that asked based on this decision. Okay, so what does this decision tree say? Decision tree ne kya bola? Decision tree has certain variables. What are these variables or these questions? Quality requirement. Number one, jahan par quality requirement. So, dekho, quality, which was factor number one, is here. Okay, the second one is commitment requirement. If the quality requirement is high, then you reach on the second factor. If your quality requirement is low, even then you reach the second factor, which is commitment, team commitment requirement. Okay. The third is leader's information. Do you or the leader have sufficient information to make a high quality decision on your own leaders information. So the third one is the level of or the amount of information that is available with the leader, that is leaders information. If the second one, that is commitment requirement, is high and quality requirement is high, then you ask the third question about leaders information. However, if your CR commitment requirement is low, then you go directly to AI, which is autocratic type 1. AI or A1 here is autocratic type 1. Okay, so this is leadership style. So this is the smallest decision tree branch that is available. So QR quality requirement is high, CR commitment requirement, quality requirement is low, commitment requirement is low. So you directly get to choose that your leadership style should be 81. Let's say your quality requirement is low, but your CR commitment requirement is high. Then you come to CP. What is CP's commitment probability? If you were to make the decision by yourself, it is reasonably certain that your subordinates would be committed to the decision. Decision maine khud liya, is it certain that subordinates will be committed to the decision or will they not be committed to the decision? Kya hoga? If the commitment requirement is high, but at the same time commitment probability is high or low. If it is commitment probability, if they are going to be committed, then again you come at 81. If the commitment probability is low, that means that if you don't consult them, then they are not going to be committed, then you come at G2, which also means group based type 2. Group based type 2. ठीक है ना, 81, 82, CT1, CT2, GT2, group based type 2. तो इस वाले decision पे आप आ जाओगे. Okay? So this is the decision tree. ये इसके बहुत सारे probabilities और बहुत सारे conditions हैं जिसके basis पे different stems are created, different processes are created, and depending upon where you lie, you keep answering these questions, and based on the answer of these questions, you come to the required leadership style, ki kaun sa leadership style mujhe follow karna hai is situation mein. In this situation, what kind of leadership style should I be following? This is what you come at based upon the answers that you get for these questions. I hope it's not buffering anymore. Somebody said that it's buffering. That's why I have to check in the other window simultaneously. No, it's not buffering anymore. Good enough. Okay. Okay, so this is what is Vroom Yeton Jago decision model. Let's have a look at the 8 questions, because a question can be asked based on these 8 questions, based on the factors, and based upon the leadership style. Teen jagah se question aa sakta hai. The question can be from 3 areas. Number 1, the factors responsible for making decisions. Number 2, the 8 questions that you can ask in order to identify what leadership style to be followed. Number 3, what are the different leadership styles that can be adopted by the manager or the leader in an organization in different situations? Okay. Now, what are these 8 questions? Number 1, quality requirement. Quality ki importance kitni zyada hai? What is the importance of quality? Number 2, commitment requirement. How important is the commitment of subordinate? Number 3, leader's information. Does the leader have sufficient information or not? Number 4, problem structure. Is the problem well structured or well defined, or is the problem very abstract in nature? Commitment probability. If you were to make the decision by yourself, is it reasonably certain that the subordinates would be committed to the decision? If you do not take their views into consideration, will they still be committed or not? If they will be committed, you go to autocratic. If they're not committed, you go to group based. That's something that we recently discussed. Goal congruence. Do subordinates share the organization goals to be attained in solving the problem? Which means that is there complete sync between individual goals and organizational goals? Subordinate conflict. Is conflict among subordinates over preferred over solutions likely? So this means subordinates ke liye conflict zyada important hai ya fir solution zyada important hai. Subordinate information. Do subordinates have sufficient information to take a high quality decision. So information is for both leader as well as subordinate. These are the 8 questions. And based upon these 8 questions, you finally come to leadership style. Leadership style that the leadership can follow. There are 5 types: autocratic type 1, autocratic type 2, consultative type 1, consultative type 2, and group based type 2. I hope it's clear. Ab ye kya hai 5? Let's understand these 5 also. Okay, autocratic type 1, very simple, autocratic in nature, in which leader alone makes the decision using information that is available at the time. Information jo uske paas hai, the information that he has, and decision making is also done alone by the leader. Autocratic type 2 is a little more liberal than autocratic type 1, in which leader collects the required information from followers, then makes the decision alone. Decision, because he is autocratic in nature, therefore the decision is still done alone, made alone, but the information is being collected from followers. Information, autocratic type 1 mein. So you have decision plus information, D plus I. D plus I, both are done by the leader here. Here, decision is done by the leader, but information belongs to the subordinate. Okay. Consultative, in which the leader shares the problem with relevant individuals and seeks their ideas and suggestions before making the decision alone. Decision abhi akele hi le raha hai, but at the same time, he is consulting the subordinates. Consultation subordinates ke saath ho raha hai. Consultative type 2 shares the problem with relevant individuals in a group setting and seeks their ideas before making the decision alone. Yahan par bhi decision akele hi liya ja raha hai, but here the consultation is done on an individual basis in consultative type 1, but here consultation is done on a group basis. Okay, group setting mein consultation hoti hai. And group based is the most liberal, where you involve yourself in brainstorming also. And at the same time, decision making is also group based. Decision making bhi group based ho gayi, and brainstorming or collection of information, identification of what decision to come at, how to come at, is done through brainstorming, which is a group setting method. I hope it's very, very clear. Vishal, I've told you what kind of questions can be asked from this. Teen areas se questions aa sakte hain. You can be asked questions from 3 areas. Number 1 was factors. You can be asked questions from these factors. Okay, with the meanings of these factors or the importance of these factors. Number 2, you can be asked questions from the decision tree, which involves 8 questions which measure the level of impact of QTT. All these 3 factors. And number 3, leadership style jo bhi adopt hoga, questions can be asked from that as well. I hope it's clear. Brainstorming is a different topic altogether. Usko discuss karne ke liye zyada time lagega, but on a very crude level, bade bahut hi zyada simple level pe bole to brainstorming mein kya hota hai, you sit together and you discuss ideas among each other, you brainstorm and try, and so you enter into a discussion debate by sitting together and you try and come to a conclusion. ठीक है ना, तो ब्रेनस्टॉर्मिंग में बहुत सारे लोग साथ में बैठ जाते हैं. स्कूल्स में भी होता था पहले, कॉल्ड एज आई थिंक ग्रुप डिसीजन मेकिंग या ग्रुप टेक्निक्स कुछ बोलते थे उसको, वेयर इन यू जस्ट सिट टुगेदर, यू गिवन अ टॉपिक एंड यू ब्रेनस्टॉर्म. उस पे कुछ लोग एंटी बोलते हैं, कुछ लोग उसके फॉर बोलते हैं. यू गिव योर आइडियाज, यू गिव योर रीजंस, एंड यू ट्राई टू कम टू अ सॉल्यूशन. ओके, एक प्रॉब्लम दे दी जाती है, यू हैव टू कम टू अ सॉल्यूशन बाय storming your brain, and a lot of people do it simultaneously at the same time. Okay, you don't need to memorize the whole tree, not at all, but ye tree memorize karne ki zarurat nahi hai. There is no chance that a question can be asked from this tree, but questions can be from these questions. Questions can be from these 8 questions. Okay, so memorize these 8 questions. Ye 8 questions ka matlab kya hai, and also memorize the leadership styles. Okay, GD, yes, group discussions. So that is a kind of brainstorming technique only. In GD, instead of giving you a problem, they give you a situation where there can be 2 or multiple answers. But in brainstorming, the idea is to pick up a problem and to identify or to figure out a solution based upon discussion. Theek hai, I hope it's clear. चलो लेट्स कम टू द सेकेंड टॉपिक, सेकेंड थ्योरी विच इज लीडर मेंबर एक्सचेंज थ्योरी, एलएमएक्स, एलएमएक्स थ्योरी. ये भी काफी लंबी थ्योरी है, इट्स अ वेरी कॉम्प्लेक्स थ्योरी. सी ऑल दीज थ्योरीज आर न्यू थ्योरीज, दे आर वेरी रिसेंटली डेवलप्ड एंड देयरफॉर दे आर मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स. हम लोग आज तक मैस्लो और वो सारी ओल्ड थ्योरीज पढ़ते आए हैं एंड वी ऑलवेज थॉट दैट मैनेजमेंट इज वेरी सिंपल टू अंडरस्टैंड, बट दीज थ्योरीज एक्चुअली टेक इट टू अ कॉम्प्लेक्स, मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स लेवल. ठीक है, तो गेयर योर सेल्फ फॉर डिस्कसिंग सम मोर कॉम्प्लेक्स थ्योरीज, बट आई कैन मेक श्योर दैट दे आर वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग इन नेचर. तो लीडर मेंबर एक्सचेंज थ्योरी एलएमएक्स पढ़ने से पहले लेट्स अंडरस्टैंड द हिस्ट्री ऑफ एलएमएक्स. हाउ डिड एलएमएस इवॉल्व? इट इवॉल्व थ्रू समथिंग कॉल्ड एज वर्टिकल डायर्ड लिंकेज, वर्टिकल डायर्ड लिंकेज वीडीएल के थ्रू ये इवॉल्व हुआ है. इट वॉज लेटर कॉल्ड एज एलएमएक्स. ओके, दीज टू पीपल ग्रेन एंड उडल बेन, वेरी डिफिकल्ट टू रिमेंबर देयर नेम, एक्सप्लेन्स दैट रिसर्च इन टू इश्यूज रिलेटिंग टू लीडर मेंबर एक्सचेंज स्टार्टेड और बिगैन विद स्टडीज ऑन वर्टिकल डायर्ड लिंकेज. वीडीएल के थ्रू स्टार्ट हुआ एज आई सेड, व्हिच फाउंड दैट मेनी मैनेजेरियल प्रोसेसेस अकर्ड ऑन अ डायडिक बेसिस विद मैनेजर्स फॉर्मिंग डिफरेंशिएटेड रिलेशनशिप्स विद दोज हु रिपोर्टेड टू देम. आई विल एक्सप्लेन टू यू, डोंट वरी अबाउट व्हाट एग्जैक्टली इज वीडीएल एंड हाउ डिड इट फंक्शन, हाउ डिड इट स्टार्ट. तो तीन ग्रुप्स बने वीडीएल के अंडर विच वर अल्टीमेटली टेकन ओवर बाय एलएमएक्स. ओके, एंड दैट इज हाउ एलएमएस. ओके, दैट इज हाउ एलएमएस, एलएमएक्स एक्चुअली इवॉल्व. सो व्हाट वर दीज थ्री ग्रुप्स? दीज वर फॉलोअर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, लीडर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स एंड इंटरपर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स. तो ये तीन ग्रुप्स बने, फॉलोअर, लीडर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, फॉलोअर कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स, इंटरपर्सनल रिलेशनशिप्स. इनके बेसिस पे एलएमएक्स वाज फॉर्म्ड. तो एलएमएक्स बोलता है दैट व्हाट इज द लेवल, व्हाट इज द लेवल एंड व्हाट इज द काइंड ऑफ एक्सचेंज बिटवीन लीडर एंड मेंबर. इट्स एज सिंपल एज दैट. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू सिंप्लीफाई इट, देन व्हाट इज द काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप ऑफ और एक्सचेंज, बिहेवियरल एक्सचेंज, मेंटल एक्सचेंज, फिजिकल एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द लीडर एंड द मेंबर विच रिजल्ट्स इन सर्टन काइंड ऑफ कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस. ओके, दिस एक्सपेरिमेंट सजेस्ट दैट इट इज अप टू द लीडर टू फॉर्म रिलेशनशिप्स नेसेसरी फॉर सक्सेसफुल इम्प्लीमेंटेशन ऑफ एलएमएक्स. इट सेज दैट इट इज अप टू द लीडर टू आइडेंटिफाई वॉट काइंड ऑफ रिलेशनशिप शुड बी क्रिएटेड विद द फॉलोअर्स सो दैट द एलएमएक्स इज सक्सेसफुल, सो दैट यू आर एबल टू अचीव योर ऑब्जेक्टिव. ओके, now what exactly are the kinds of exchanges or relationships created and how are they created? Okay, so leader and member develop relationships as soon as a member enters an organization. So the process is when a new member enters the organization, there is something called as role taking. What happens in role taking is when a new member joins a team and their abilities are initially assessed by the leader. Let's say यू आर दी मैनेजर ऑफ अ ब्रांच, असिस्टेंट मैनेजर हो आप और ट्रांसफर होते रहते हैं इफ यू आर वर्किंग इन अ पब्लिक सेक्टर बैंक. लेट्स से यू आर द मैनेजर एंड अ न्यू कैशियर कम्स इन योर बैंक. जो कैशियर काम कर रहा था ही लीव्स, द कैशियर हु वाज वर्किंग ही लीव्स, ही इज ट्रांसफर्ड एंड लेट्स से अ न्यू कैशियर कम्स इन योर ब्रांच. ओके, अ वेरी हाइपोथेटिकल एग्जाम्पल. एंड द फर्स्ट थिंग दैट यू आर गोइंग टू डू इज यू आर गोइंग टू ट्राई एंड आइडेंटिफाई वेदर दिस न्यू कैशियर हैज द एबिलिटी टू वर्क एज अ कैशियर और नॉट, हाउ गुड और हाउ बैड इज ही. सबसे पहले आप यही करोगे. देन द सेकेंड वुड बी रोल मेकिंग, वेर अ रोल इज क्रिएटेड फॉर द मेंबर, क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ द मेंबर इन टू इन ग्रुप एंड आउट ग्रुप. ये समझ लेते हैं, दिस इज अ लिटिल इंपॉर्टेंट. सो वट यूल डू इज यू विल आइडेंटिफाई वेदर ही इज गुड एज अ कैशियर और नॉट. लेट से नेगेटिव सिचुएशन, यू आर एबल टू आइडेंटिफाई कि भाई इसको तो नहीं आता कैशियर का काम करना, हिज बेसिक्स आर नॉट क्लियर, ही डजंट नो हाउ टू काउंट मनी, ही डजंट नो हाउ टू हैंडल मनी, ही इज नॉट अ गुड कैशियर. यू आइडेंटिफाई दैट, यू हैव द पावर टू शिफ्ट हिम टू अनदर वर्क एंड पुट समवन एल्स एज अ कैशियर. यू हैव द पावर टू डू दैट. सो यू आइडेंटिफाई अ न्यू रोल फॉर हिम विच यू थिंक ही कैन एक्चुअली डू एंड यू पुट समवन एल्स ऑन द एज द कैशियर इन द ब्रांच. And then at the same time, you identify this person in your mind as either belonging to in group or belonging to out group. आप अपने दिमाग के अंदर इन ग्रुपिंग एंड आउट ग्रुपिंग कर लेते हो. इन ग्रुपिंग इज पीपल और सबॉर्डिनेट्स दैट यू लाइक, दैट यू ट्रस्ट, दैट यू थिंक कैन एक्चुअली टेक अ लॉट ऑफ योर रिस्पॉन्सिबिलिटीज. एंड आउट ग्रुप्स आर पीपल हु यू डोंट लाइक पर्सनली एज वेल एज प्रोफेशनली, हु यू थिंक आर नॉट कॉम्पिटेंट इनफ एंड हु यू वॉन्ट टू कीप एट अ डिस्टेंस एंड जस्ट लेट देम डू द वर्क, दैट्स इट. ओके, यू डोंट वॉन्ट देम टू बी a part of your decision making. You want them to be just followers and not leaders themselves in the future. To apne in grouping out grouping kar li, let's say after role taking you identify that he's not a good cashier and therefore you don't like him, you put it on some other job, and then in your mind you put it put him as a part of out group. And the third one is routinization, where routines, norms and expectations are established and both parties can get an insight into how you both work. So you put him on something else and then you try and create a routine wherein you identify how is he performing in the new job, because he's a new person in the branch. The person who's now put on the responsibility of cashier is actually an old person. He's been in the branch, so you know how is he performing. But this new person, you don't have any idea about him. So you create a routine, you identify what are the expectations from him, what kind of work is he doing, and he also does the same with you. That's why there is an exchange between leader and member. So this is called as leader member exchange theory. Now LMX theory ko agar aur detail mein chalenge, this is the process, but if we bifurcate characteristics further of all the people who are part of the exchange, then this is the graph that is created. Okay, follower ki characteristics hongi number 1, leader ki characteristics hongi number 2, interpersonal relationships hongi number 3, then there will be contextual variables which basically are situations hongi number 4, and based upon these four variables you will arrive at the consequences. Aapko pata lag jayega ki in char variables ki exchange se what are the consequences, kya consequences ho rahe hain, whether they are positive or whether they are negative. Font size bhai increase ho nahi sakta hai, the reason is that the chart itself is too big, to usko ppt mein dalne ke liye I need some space. Okay, that is the reason that font size cannot increase further, usse zyada bada ho hi nahi sakta hai. Okay, so I'll tell you all the characteristics, don't worry about that. Okay, so what are the follower characteristics? Competence, agreeableness, conscientiousness, extraversion, neuroticism, openness, positive affectivity, negative affectivity, locus of control. Sare yaad karne ki zarurat nahi hai, not going to be asked in the examination. Isme ek to 5 big traits bhi hain. If you remember, we had discussed 5 big traits in the past in the course itself. To 5 big traits bhi hain isme, iske andar competence, agreeableness, conscientiousness, extraversion, openness. Ek, do, teen, char, panch. We are done with 5. So, and these others are new ones. Neuroticism, positive affectivity, negative affectivity, locus of control. So, ye characteristics hain follower ke. Inke explanations nahi puche jayenge exam mein, not possible. And the same way, we have characteristics of the leader. So, jab wo exchange karenge, when they get to know each other, then these characteristics need to sync with each other. Otherwise, the consequences will be negative. Supervisors, expectations of followers, expectations zyada hai ya kam hai, what is the level of expectations, contingent reward behavior, if you as a follower are doing well, how does the leader reward you, transformational leadership hai ya nahi hai, is it transformational leadership or is it transactional leadership that he's following, extroversion, does he like to talk a lot or not, agreeableness, does he seek for your agreeableness? Does he seek for your agreement on everything or not? So these are different characteristics that a leader might also have. And then you have interpersonal relationships. Matlab, dono ke exchange mein kya relationships hain? Perceived similarity hai ke nahi hai? Supervisor reported, ingratiation, subordinate reported, self-promotion, assertiveness, leader trust. All these are interpersonal relationships which exist between leader and follower. Ab kuch situations hongi, the situations might differ. Okay, work setting kaisi hai, what is the kind of work setting, is it authoritative, do you get enough time to socialize with each other, what is the location of the participant, cultural dimensions kya hai, If you're working in Indian branch in an Indian bank, sorry, if you're working in a PSU, let's say SBI, the cultural dimensions are different. If you're working in, let's say, ICICI or HDFC, the cultural dimensions are completely different. Okay, what are the consequences? Alag alag consequences honge. They might be positive, they might be negative in nature. Job performance might be impacted positively or negatively. Organizational commitment might be affected. Job satisfaction might be affected. Procedural justice might be seen or not seen. Distributive justice might be seen or not seen. Distributive justice means that the lead, the member, the follower might feel that he's not being paid according to his work, or he is being paid more, or he's being paid equal to what he deserves. Empowerment, feeling of empowerment or disempowerment. Okay. Role conflict. The cashier, the new person who was supposed to be working as a cashier, might feel that his role was something else, and now he's been given something else which he's not an expert in. So there might be a role conflict. Okay. So this is what is leader member exchange theory. हमने start कहाँ से किया? History थी vertical dyad linkage में. उसमें पाया गया कि there are different relationships between the managers and the followers. So that was vertical dyad linkage. कि एक vertical linkage है between managers and followers, और उन दोनों के रिलेशनशिप की वजह से, रिलेशनशिप के कॉन्सिक्वेंसेस होते हैं विच कैन बी पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव. देयर इज अ ऑनगोइंग एक्सचेंज बिटवीन द लीडर एंड द फॉलोअर, एंड बेस्ड अपॉन देयर एक्सचेंज वी सी द कॉन्सिक्वेंसेज विच माइट बी पॉजिटिव और नेगेटिव. एंड बेस्ड अपॉन दैट लीडर मेंबर एक्सचेंज थ्योरी क्रिएटेड दिस चार्ट थ्रू विच यू अंडरस्टैंड द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ फॉलोअर्स, कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ लीडर्स and the situations in order to identify what can be the possible consequences. And then at the same time, the LMX theory also created the process in which routinization is the end, in which the leader and the follower enter into an exchange. Theek hai na? I hope it's clear. Let's take some questions. Compile all the videos related to SEBI 2020 in a playlist. Shweta, SEBI 2020 ki ek playlist nahi hogi, but these playlists are dependent upon the topics, because otherwise it becomes very confusing. Okay, because a lot of things that I'm teaching here for SEBI are also relevant for RBI, so it's basically creating more confusion agar main khali SEBI ka ek playlist bana lu. Identify ki kon kon se topics aapko padhne hain SEBI mein, aur un sab ki playlist available hai already. Okay, to thoda sa kaam aapko bhi karna padega wahan par. Abhijit yaar, ye eligibility wala question baad mein पूछ लेना, नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट राइट नाउ. लेट्स फोकस ऑन स्टडिंग अ लिटिल बिट. अर्ली इन द मॉर्निंग 10:37 थोड़ा सा पढ़ लेते हैं, देन वी कैन एक्चुअली कम टू दीज ऑपरेशनल इश्यूज कि मैं एलिजिबल हूं या नहीं हूं. ओके, द क्वेश्चन, द नेक्स्ट थ्योरी दैट वी हैव. अब हमने क्या कर लिया, व्हाट ऑल हैव वी डन? वी आर डन विद द फर्स्ट थ्योरी, विक्टर व्रूम येटॉन जागो डिसीजन मॉडल. We are done with LMX theory. The next one is French and Revan's five forms of power. French and Revan's five forms of power. Okay. Very simple theory, very small theory. I think एक पेज की theory है. So very simple and small theory. Five forms of power समझ लोगे, you are done. Okay. What exactly French and Revan said was that what is it that makes someone powerful in a given setting? अब यहाँ पे भी देखो, गिवन सेटिंग जरूर डाला है, बिकॉज सो एलएमएस आल्सो टुक इनटू कंसिडरेशन द सिचुएशन. द फर्स्ट वन व्रूम येटॉन जागो मॉडल आल्सो कंसिडर्ड सिचुएशन. द थर्ड वन फ्रेंच एंड रेवन आल्सो कंसिडर्ड द सिचुएशन. सो ही सेड, और दीज गाइस सेड दैट देयर आर फाइव फॉर्म्स ऑफ पावर विच कैन बी यूज बाय समवन टू स्टे पावरफुल इन डिफरेंट सिचुएशंस. सिचुएशन के बेसिस पे, depending on the situation, the kind of power that you can use will also vary. Jo aapki situation hogi, let's say there are three broad situations which you have classified. Okay, situation, in situation one, legitimate power might be useful. In situation two, reward power might be useful. In situation three, coercive power might be useful. It depends on the situation. Based upon the situation, the kind of power will also vary. But what they said was that your power in the organization will depend on what kind of power use in what kind of situation. Okay. And then they also created a sixth power, which was called as informational power. Now let's go through these five powers first, one by one, and then let's go to the informational power. Okay. Legitimate power. Legitimate power comes from a position or role. Power of Prime Minister of India to shut down the entire country in the name of coronavirus, saying that coronavirus is spreading and it's affecting people, it's dreadful for the nation. He has been given that position. He holds that position or role, and he has the legitimate power to actually take this decision. ठीक है ना? हमें वो मानना पड़ेगा. We have to agree to it because he has legitimacy to take that decision. Okay. It might be that he has other powers as well, but at the same time, he's the one who has taken that decision because he has legitimacy over it. Nobody can, people can criticize or people can agree or disagree, but you cannot say that the Prime Minister cannot take this decision. He can and he did take this decision because he has legitimacy. The second one is reward power, ability to give rewards. Now, I have the ability to give you rewards based upon your performance. Let's say RBI mein selection main karwa raha hun. Let's say ki I am the one who's checking the papers, I'm the one who's setting the papers. Then I have the power of reward. So, jo bhi main bolunga, aap wo manenge because I have the ability to reward you based upon your performance. Aap jaisa perform karenge, I'm the one, if I'm the one who's rewarding you, then you listen to me. If RBI is the one who's rewarding you, you listen to RBI. If RBI changes the syllabus today and I tell you, nahi ye wala syllabus mat padho, keep reading whatever you've been reading, the past questions will come from that only, you won't listen to me because the ability or the power to reward you, here the reward being your selection or non-selection, is with RBI. Theek hai na? I hope that's clear. I think that's a good example that you can use in any setting. The third is coercive, ability to punish. Coercive power. आप एग्जाम में जाते हो, you go into the examination hall. Let's say you have a mobile phone. आपके पास मोबाइल फोन है. आप एग्जाम में गए, आपके पास मोबाइल फोन है, which is prohibited, not allowed. Then the examination hall authorities have the power to punish you based upon the mobile phone. So they have a coercive power. ठीक है ना? उनके पास वो coercive power है. They have the ability to punish you. Expert power, having superior knowledge. मेरे पास आपसे ज़्यादा knowledge है. तो आप मेरी सुनेंगे. इफ यू हैव मोर नॉलेज देन आई हैव, देन आई विल हैव टू लिसन टू यू. इन टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू इंजीनियरिंग, इन टॉपिक्स रिलेटेड टू मेडिसिन, आई हैव नो नॉलेज, सो आई विल बी लुकिंग आफ्टर, आई विल बी लुकिंग फॉर पीपल हु आर एक्सपर्ट्स इन दैट फील्ड. इन एरियाज रिलेटेड टू फाइनेंस, इन एरियाज रिलेटेड टू कॉमर्स, आई बिलीव दैट आई हैव सम काइंड ऑफ एक्सपर्टीज, सो पीपल माइट लिसन टू मी. सो इट इज बेस्ड अपॉन योर एक्सपर्टीज एंड नॉट अपॉन लेजिटिमेसी, रिवॉर्ड और कोएर्शन. ओके. अब प्रधानमंत्री भी जो हैं, he listens to experts in identifying कि भाई how to stop coronavirus. So in that case, the expert has more power over the PM in that particular situation. Referent power, popularity, attitude, charm, popularity of people, giving them some power over other people. मैं ज़्यादा popular हूँ, मेरी ज़्यादा power है. आप कम popular हैं, आपकी कम power है. गांधी, महात्मा गांधी also had some form of charisma and referent power based upon his popularity. He was very popular among the masses. If log follow karte the unko blindly, that's why he had a lot of referent power also. And the last one that they talked about is informational power. This results from a person's ability to control the information that others need to accomplish something. Ab the difference between expert and information is bahut zyada confusion hota hai. A lot of confusion takes place between these two. Expert is based upon your expert knowledge. Information power is based upon your ability to control the information that is required to accomplish something, that is required to come to a solution, that is required to achieve something, that is required to solve a problem. Aapko, let's say you have the information, you are in an organization and you have the information, let's say I am an audit firm. And this audit firm is auditing the documents of, let's say, Nirav Modi. Okay, auditing the documents of Nirav Modi, his organization. So whoever that person might be, the audit firm itself, that person might be That person might be an actual person who is actually holding all the information, holding all the information that is relevant for identifying whether Nirav Modi was a fraud or not. The person who holds this information, or the audit firm that holds this information, or the department or ministry that holds this information, is powerful in that particular situation. Uske paas asli power hai, because based upon that information only, it can be identified whether Nirav Modi was a fraud or not. Okay. Venkatesh is saying, for example, staying updated with company circulars is informational. Yes, because you have, no, you're not controlling the information in this case. You're actually updating yourself with the information. See, these two are different things. That's what I'm trying to explain. Expert mein kya ho raha hai? You have some expert knowledge. Aapke paas knowledge hai. Information mein, aapke paas information to hai hi. You have the information, but you have the ability to control the information. The audit firm or the department in this case have the ability to control the information, whether to control the information about Nirav Modi. Okay, whether it is Nirav Modi's financial documents or anything else, they have access to that information and they have the ability to control that information. That is what gives them power. Not the knowledge about the information, but the ability to control the information. Knowledge about the information takes them into expert power, but the ability to control the information, to distribute the information, gives them information power. I hope it's clear. Okay. Let's come to the next one. Fourth theory pe aate hain. The fourth theory is Bass transformational theory. Bass transformational theory. Bahut simple si theory hai. Yes, not a very big theory. One second. LMX ho gaya. Five forms of power is done. Now we have Bass transformation theory. Who is a transformation leader? So we are answering two questions through Bass's transformational theory. In logon ne do question answer kiye. Identify who is a transformational leader and how does he transform his followers. Do questions ko answer kiya hai is transformational theory ke andar. So it is based upon the ability of leader to transform the situation and the followers. So the first question that they answered, that this theory answered, was who is a transformational leader? Transformational leader hota kya hai? Yes, Mayank is very right. Confidential information. So coming to Bass transformational theory, who is a transformational leader? That is the first question that they answered. And the second question that he answered, this theory answered, is how does he transform his followers? Ab leader to transformational hai, but wo followers ko transform kaise karta hai? That is the second question that was answered. Okay. So transformational leader ke liye, he came out, Bass came out with four eyes. He said these four eyes together create a transformational leader. What are these? Individualized consideration, inspirational motivation, idealized influence, intellectual stimulation. Bhai, you have to mug up these four eyes. Very important. Questions can directly come from these four eyes with very high chances. So please remember these four eyes. Okay. Individualized consideration matlab leader, how much time and how much effort is he putting on every individual, on every follower. The extent to which a leader attends to each follower's needs and is a mentor, coach or guide to the follower. How much time, how much efforts am I spending with every follower? That is individualized consideration. How much consideration is being paid to every individual? That is individualized consideration. I hope that's clear. The second one is inspirational motivation. The degree to which a leader articulates an appealing vision that inspires and motivates others to perform beyond expectation. The level to which I can inspire you, that is inspirational motivation. Okay. So transformational leader ki pehli trait kya hai? What is the first trait or element that makes up a transformational leader? I should have more and more individualized consideration. The second one is inspirational motivation. I should be able to inspire you as a follower. Idealized influence. Leaders that are role models for their followers because they engage in high standards of ethical behavior. The level of ethics that is followed in my organization and transformed or flow down from the leader to the follower, that is idealized influence. मेरे आइडियल्स कितने स्ट्रांग हैं एंड मैं अपने स्ट्रांग आइडियल्स किस तरह से फॉलोअर्स को कम्युनिकेट कर पाता हूँ, दैट इज आइडियलाइज्ड इन्फ्लुएंस. ओके, व्हाट इज द लेवल ऑफ स्ट्रेंथ ऑफ माय आइडियल्स, ऑफ माय एथिक्स, एंड हाउ एम आई एबल टू कम्युनिकेट दोज एथिक्स एंड आइडियल्स टू द फॉलोअर्स इज आइडियलाइज्ड इन्फ्लुएंस. इफ दे आर वेरी स्ट्रांग, आई एम अ वेरी गुड ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर, अदरवाइज नॉट. इंटेलेक्चुअल स्टिमुलेशन, द एक्सटेंट टू विच लीडर्स चैलेंज अजम्पशंस, टेक रिस्क एंड सॉलिसिट फॉलोअर्स आइडियाज. ओके, द लेवल टू विच आई एम वर्किंग हार्डर देन द फॉलोअर्स, द लेवल टू विच आई एम चैलेंजिंग अजम्पशंस एंड मेकिंग इनोवेशन एंड टेकिंग रिस्क एंड अचीविंग पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट, गेटिंग पॉजिटिव रिजल्ट इन दोज रिस्क. ओके, एंड द लेवल टू विच आई एम सॉलिसिटिंग फॉलोअर्स आइडियाज, आई एम स्टिम्युलेटिंग फॉलोअर्स टू कम आउट विद आइडियाज एंड आई एम यूजिंग गुड आइडियाज टू मेक चेंजेस इन द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एंड आउटसाइड द ऑर्गेनाइजेशन एज वेल. ओके, सो दीज आर द फोर आईज ऑफ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर: इंडिविजुअलाइज्ड कंसिडरेशन, इंस्पिरेशनल मोटिवेशन, आइडियलाइज इन्फ्लुएंस एंड इंटेलेक्चुअल स्टिम्युलेशन. ओके, ये चार हमारे फोर आईज हो गए, विच आंसर द क्वेश्चन हु इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर. नाउ हाउ डज ही ट्रांसफॉर्म द फॉलोअर्स. अब हमने ये तो आइडेंटिफाई कर लिया भाई ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर कौन है, हु इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर, बट हाउ डज ही ट्रांसफॉर्म हिज फॉलोअर्स. देर आर थ्री वेज इन विच लीडर्स ट्रांसफॉर्म फॉलोअर्स: इंक्रीज देयर अवेयरनेस ऑफ टास्क इंपॉर्टेंस एंड वैल्यू. टास्क की इंपॉर्टेंस, टास्क की वैल्यू के बारे में बताओ. यू टेल योर फॉलोअर्स अबाउट द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ द टास्क एंड द वैल्यू ऑफ द टास्क. लेट मी गिव यू अ वेरी ब्रीफ एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस. लेट्स से टुमारो अ पर्सन कम्स टू मी एंड टेल्स मी, लॉट ऑफ स्टूडेंट्स कीप कमिंग टू मी एंड दे टेल मी, सर आई एम ऑल्सो इंटरेस्टेड इन टीचिंग, प्लीज हायर मी. And the first level of contact, the first level of examination is to identify their strengths and weaknesses with respect to their expertise. Okay, you're an engineer, you want to teach finance, are you good enough? Do you actually understand finance? Do you actually understand the basics and the concepts and fundamentals of economics or not? Okay, that is the first. Let's say I hire a person because I think he's an expert and he's good, but then I find that although he's a very expert, a very good expert, very well known in that particular area, he knows way too much, way good, he has good amount of knowledge, but he feels that the task is not so important. He does not value the task, he does not give any importance to the task because he is not able to identify with the task. So I tell them, I sit with him and I tell them, bhai, you are good at what you do, but you have to understand that based upon your work, based upon your effort, the student's ability to clear or not to clear the examination depends. Okay, if you are teaching well and if you're teaching with full commitment, the chances of your students or our students getting through the examination are more. If you are not doing your work, if you feel that the work is not important enough, if you're lackadaisical in your work, in your attitude, then it is affecting the student directly and not only me, not only this organization. So you give a purpose, give a vision to the person, to the follower, by telling them about the actual importance and value of the task. Okay, jab tak task ki value aur importance nahi bataoge, tab tak follower transform nahi hoga. Banking mein bhi hua, when we had abhi corona is going on for quite some time, and we had some other situations in the past when the bankers were required to work overtime. So in that situation, it was important for the leaders, for the branch managers, to tell the workers in the branch about the importance and value of their work. Okay, getting them to focus first on team or organizational goals rather than their own interest. Let's say you want your followers to work on Saturdays from now on. It's a 5-day week, but you want to turn it into a 6-day week because of certain organizational goals that you want to achieve in the next 3 months, 6 months, and so on and so on. So now their own interests are being hampered, but you want them to actually agree with your decision. So you tell them about organizational goals, why you're doing it, and you also communicate the importance of these organizational goals for their personal interest as well. That is how you transform your follower. And the third one is activating their हायर ऑर्डर नीड्स। तो मैस्लो की आपने हायर ऑर्डर नीड्स तो पढ़ी होंगी, जिसमें सेल्फ एक्चुअलाइजेशन, इंटरनल एस्टीम आता है। ओके, सो एक्टिवेटिंग देयर हायर ऑर्डर नीड्स सो दैट दे आर इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द वर्क रादर देन बीइंग इन्फ्लुएंस्ड बाय द पे और द रिवॉर्ड्स दैट आर कनेक्टेड विद दैट वर्क। ओके, आई होप दैट्स क्लियर। ओके, गुड इनफ, नो क्वेश्चन सर। तो अब हमने दो चीजें आंसर कर ली इन बास ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल थ्योरी। वी आंसर द क्वेश्चन ऑफ हु इज अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर एंड वी आंसर द क्वेश्चन ऑफ हाउ कैन अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर हाउ कैन अ ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल लीडर ट्रांसफॉर्म हिज फॉलोअर्स। ओके, वॉट आर द वेज इन विच अ लीडर कैन ट्रांसफॉर्म हिज followers. Now the third question is also answered along with the two questions that were primary contributions of Bass transformational theory is to tell three moral aspects for authentic transformational leadership. He focused on morals and ethics more than other theorists, and he said that there are three moral aspects that every transformational leader should be concerned about. And what are these three moral aspects? Number one, the moral character of the leader. Number two, the ethical value embedded in leader's vision, articulation, and program. Mera jo vision hai, if I am a leader, the vision that I have, is it about earning more money? Is it about making more selections? Is it about spreading education? Is it about spreading knowledge? What exactly is my vision? So the ethical values that are embedded in my vision, the vision might also be very umbrella-like and vague in nature. But there are always certain ethical values attached to a leader's vision. And the followers, before following the leader's vision, need to identify whether there are certain ethical values embedded in that vision or not. The morality of the processes of social ethical choice. Matlab, jo bhi leader batayega karne ke liye, whatever leader says, the followers have to do. What is the morality of the processes? Let's say the leader says, the end is good, but the process is bad. ओके, जैसे एमबीओ में होता है, मैनेजमेंट बाय ऑब्जेक्टिव में होता है, यू आर कंसर्न्ड विद द ऑब्जेक्टिव, यू आर कंसर्न्ड विद द एंड रिजल्ट, यू आर नॉट कंसर्न्ड विद द प्रोसेसेस। ओके, लेट्स से द लीडर सेज द सेम थिंग, द एंड इज गुड, द रिजल्ट इज गुड, द रिजल्ट इज मॉरल, द रिजल्ट इज गोइंग टू पॉजिटिवली अफेक्ट द सोसाइटी, बट द प्रोसेस इज बैड, द प्रोसेस इज गोइंग टू नेगेटिवली अफेक्ट, देन ही इज लॉस्ट ऑन वन मॉरल एस्पेक्ट, द मॉरलिटी ऑफ द प्रोसेस is not there. Okay, so these are the three questions that he answered, one and two being the primary questions. The third question about moral aspects for authentic transformational leader being an add-on that Bass transformational theory provided. So now we are done with, let's come back, revise karte hain ek bar, not the theories but what all theories have we covered. We've covered Vroom Yet on Jago, we've covered LMX, we've covered five forms of power, we've covered transformational theory. Okay, now we have to cover leadership participation इन्वेंट्री, लीडरशिप पार्टिसिपेशन इन्वेंट्री कवर करते हैं, ठीक है। सो दिस इज लीडरशिप पार्टिसिपेशन इन्वेंट्री। इसमें बताया गया कि पांच तरीके हैं, देर आर फाइव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट मेक अ गुड लीडर। सो देर आर दीज फाइव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट मेक अ गुड लीडर। ओके, एंड दिस इज ऑल देर इज टू लीडरशिप पार्टिसिपेशन इन्वेंट्री। जेम काउज एंड बेरी पॉस्नर मॉडल भी बोलते हैं इसको, इट इज ऑल्सो कॉल्ड एज जेम काउज एंड मेरी बेरी पॉस्नर मॉडल, एंड दे आइडेंटिफाइड फाइव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स दैट मेक अ गुड लीडर। व्हाट आर दीज फाइव कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स? नंबर वन, मॉडल द वे, मॉडल द वे, मॉडल द वे क्या बोलता है? प्रिंसिपल्स, मॉडल द वे टेल्स द प्रिंसिपल्स ऑन हाउ पीपल शुड बी ट्रीटेड एंड हाउ दे शुड परस्यू गोल्स। सो मॉडल द वे सेज व्हाट आर द प्रिंसिपल्स, सो द एबिलिटी of a leader to identify and communicate the principles on how people should be treated and how they should pursue goals, how they should be treated in an organization and how they should pursue the goals in the organization. To model the way matlab maine rasta dikhaya aapko, this is what the picture also clarifies. The leader is creating a way through principles on how the followers should be treated, number one, and how they should pursue the goals in order to achieve organizational goals. To rasta dikhana matlab model the way. The second one is shared vision, inspire a shared vision. So first of all, you create a vision, you create an organizational vision. To jo humne pichle model mein bhi padha, You need to create an organizational vision, and you need to have the employees or the followers partner in your vision. Let's say my vision is to make more and more people expert, or make more and more people more aware about basic financing, okay, so that they can understand and handle their finances. That's my broad vision. The level to which I can attach my employees to that shared vision, to that vision, and created their vision as well, is what makes me a good or a bad leader. Agar main apne employees ko apne vision mein partner nahi bana sakta, if I'm not able to make my employees a partner in my vision, then I'm not a good leader. If I can, then I'm a good leader. Okay. The third one is challenge the process. Basically, the ability to innovate, to accept failures and risks that are taken, is challenging the process. The level to which main ek achha leader hoon, I am a good leader, I am a transformational leader, if I am able to innovate, if I am able to accept failures and risks, and yet keep going on taking more and more risks and try and be successful in those risks. The next one is enable to act, enabling others to act. So this is very important, because a lot of people have this problem of micromanaging that I've actually seen in different organizations. Even in banks, I've seen that a lot. The managers, because they don't understand ki bhai, micromanaging nahi kar sakte ho. It's not only harmful for the work, it's also harmful for you. It's also harmful for the competence and level of confidence that the follower might have, that the employees might have. So enable to act bolta hai, enable others to act bolta hai. It says that you have to be confident about your employees. You have to ensure, and you have to believe that they are capable, that they are powerful, that they are able to take decisions, that they can be trusted, and you have to accept their human dignity. That is enabling others to act. And the last one is encouraging the heart, which means to celebrate accomplishments. Aapne kuch accomplish kiya. In this example, Dhoni comes to my mind. When he actually won the World Cup, he did not come in the front to receive the World Cup. He allowed Virat Kohli and others, who were the youngsters at that time, to come and receive the cup and to celebrate. So he encouraged the heart. He allowed them to celebrate. He gave them that opportunity to celebrate their accomplishments. Okay. And that's why they felt like heroes at that point of time. He would have, if he wanted to, celebrated on his own, taken the cup on his own. That has happened in the past in a lot of situations, but he did not do that. So that was a very important aspect of a good leader. That is how he differentiated himself, or he put himself in a class apart from others. Okay. March month ka spotlight, Sridhar, is already published. PIB probably by tomorrow or day after. It takes 2-3 days to compile everything. Thoda sa time lag jata hai. Okay. But otherwise, March is done. And the RBI 247 of March is also done. Wo bhi ek do din mein compile hoke, it will be available. Okay. Second point of how does leader transform his followers? So there's a question. How does leader transform his followers? Getting them to focus first on team or organizational goals rather than their own interests. So the question that Shweta has asked is the second point of BAS transformational theory. So see, there are some organizational goals and there are some personal interests. Let's say my personal interest is to work from 10 to 5, 5 baje ghar jana aur chill karna uske baad. To go out with my friends, have fun, that is my personal interest. But my organizational goal is, let's say, abhi emergency situation hai, let's say doctors, whatever is happening to doctors right now, their personal interest would be to work, to go to the clinic 2-3 times a day, 2 hours each, and that's it. But the organization, in this case, which is the country, requires them to actually sit for long hours, check all the people who are suffering from COVID-19. So that is an organizational goal. So the A good follower is a one, a good leader is a one, a good transformational leader is a one who is able to get the followers, in this case the doctors, to focus on organizational goals rather than their individual interest. That is a good transformational leader. Okay, I hope that's clear. Nay, Chinmay is saying all theories more or less similar. They look similar because they're all based upon situation. That's what I said. They're all situational theories because they're recent theories. Recently, kya hua hai in everything that management studies, situation is one common factor, because this is something that they've realized, that situation cannot be eliminated. In the previous theories, in the older ancient theories, we did not have situation. But other than that, बहुत सारी चीजें अलग हैं. See, here we are talking only about transformational leader. In this case, we are not talking about transformational leader. We are talking about what are the ways in which you can become or you can hold power over your followers. यहाँ पर हम exchange की बात कर रहे हैं. We are not talking about leading and following. We are talking about how manager and follower, manager and subordinate exchange ideas and connect with each other. Okay? लीडरशिप पार्टिसिपेशन इन्वेंट्री, यहाँ पे हम बात कर रहे हैं हाउ कैन बी अ लीडर अ गुड लीडर. यहाँ पे हमने बिल्कुल अलग पांच आइडेंटिफिकेशन किए हैं, पांच क्लासिफिकेशन किए हैं. ट्रांसफॉर्मेशनल थ्योरी में क्लासिफिकेशन पांच नहीं थे, अलग थे, एंड द फोकस वॉज ऑल्सो कम्प्लीटली डिफरेंट. वहां पे फोकस था या तो वो ऑर्गेनाइजेशन, जो अभी श्वेता ने पूछा, getting them to focus on organizational goals, task की importance or value, higher order needs, but ये तीनों चीज पॉस्नर मॉडल में नहीं है. ऑल दीज थ्री थिंग्स आर नॉट हेयर इन पॉस्नर मॉडल. सो ऑल दीज मॉडल्स आर फोकसिंग ऑन डिफरेंट थिंग्स. यू माइट नॉट फील दैट दे आर इम्पॉर्टेंट इनफ, बट जब एक्चुअल एग्जाम्पल्स विच आई एम ट्राइंग टू प्रोवाइड टू यू से सिंक करोगे, देन यू विल आइडेंटिफाई ईच ट्रेट इज सो इम्पॉर्टेंट. लेट्स से यू हैव ऑल द कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स ऑफ अ गुड लीडर एंड यू विन समथिंग. लेट्स से यू गेट द वर्ल्ड कप, जो भी मैंने एग्जाम्पल दिया था धोनी वाला, यू गेट द वर्ल्ड कप or you achieve something great, but at the same time you don't have this trait of encouraging the heart. You will end up celebrating alone, and you will end up seeing your downfall after that. Aap apna downfall dekhoge hi dekhoge, because you would have actually celebrated alone and ignored all your followers. To ek acha leader wo hota hai who starts on a positive note and ends on a positive note. Okay, so this is the way a good leader can be created. So all these theories, all these small small traits are equally important. To ye sochna ki ye bahut same same baatein kar rahi hai, it's very crude. Lot of questions coming up. Chalo abhi let's focus on Likert system for management. Likert wala bahut simple hai. Questions have been asked from Likert system for management in the past, and they're expected to be asked in the future also, because it's a very popular theory. So Likert said very simple, in very simple terms, that there are four systems, four kinds of leaders that can be created: exploitative authoritative, benevolent authoritative, consultative and democratic. Char tarike ke leaders hote hain. There are four kinds of leaders that can be created based upon different variables. जो भी variable है उसके basis पे आप identify करोगे कि आपको कौन से type का leader बनना है. Based upon the variable, you will identify what kind of leader do you want to be. Extent to which superior have confidence and trust on subordinates. देखो, कुछ organizations होती हैं, specially service organizations, where the leaders need to have a lot of confidence and trust in the subordinates. On the other hand, there are a lot of manufacturing and trading organizations where the leaders do not have a lot of confidence in their subordinates. Subordinates ke upar, followers ke upar bahut zyada confidence nahi hota hai, because the level at which you're working, the kind of people that you're working with, the kind of work that you're doing also differentiates, creates a difference whether you can have confidence and trust on your subordinates or not. To agar aapke paas koi bhi bilkul bhi trust nahi hai, you don't have any trust in your subordinates, then you will be under system one, exploitative authoritative. Let's say cricket team ki baat karte hain. Trust or confidence chahiye na on the team members. Team members being followers here, and the leader is the captain. So because it's like a service industry where you need a lot of confidence and trust. You cannot be exploitative, authoritative in nature. Aap yahan par nahi lie kar sakte. Dhoni cannot lie here. Dhoni has to be somewhere here or here. Has condescending confidence and trust such as master has on servant. Master-servant relationship does not survive in a game like cricket, in a game like football. Okay, because the leader and the follower need to be closely knit together. They need to have a lot of confidence and trust in each other. They need to play like a team. Otherwise, they will not succeed. So, benevolent authoritative will not work in cricket also. Okay. Consultative. Substantial but not complete confidence and trust still wishes to keep control of decisions. Yahan pe decision making mein control hai. And complete confidence and trust in all matters. Pura confidence or trust in all matters. So, what will happen is, Dhoni might have complete confidence and trust in Virat Kohli, in let's say Rohit Sharma, in a lot of other members of the team, but he might not have complete confidence and trust in some members of the team. In that situation, what will happen is he will be following two systems of leadership where he'll be in the democratic mode when dealing with these followers and in consultative mode when he's dealing with the other team members. I hope that's clear. So a leader need not be only limited to one kind of leadership system. He can actually be a part of multiple systems as well. Yahan pe keywords yaad karne zaruri hain. If you've understood what exactly I'm talking about, the next step is to remember the keywords. Exploitative authoritative, no trust and confidence. Benevolent authoritative, condescending confidence and trust, such as master has on servant. Consultative, substantial but not complete. These are the keywords. And democratic, complete confidence and trust. So this was the first variable, level of confidence that you have. Level of confidence, superiors. Subordinates do not feel at all free. Dekho, yahan pe toh, it's flowing from the superior to the subordinate, the first variable. The second variable is flowing from the subordinate to the superior. Flowing from the subordinate, feelings of the subordinate. In the first one, confidence and trust that the superior has. So second variable is complete opposite of first variable. That's how you can remember it. Subordinates do not feel at all free to discuss things about the job with the superior. Koi bhi freedom nahi hai. Subordinates ko lagta hai, main usko bataunga. He'll take it negatively. He'll punish me instead. So let's not tell him anything. So there's no trust. And at the same time, subordinates do not feel free to discuss anything. Subordinates in benevolent authoritative do not feel free, very free to discuss things about the job with their superior. Dekho, yahan pe at all hai, yahan pe very hai. That's the only difference. Because it's an old theory, system 4 management wali, not very new theory. Isliye, he's played around with words a little. In consultative, subordinates feel rather free. And in democratic, subordinates feel completely free. Very subjective in nature, but organizations mein, you can actually divide your subordinates in these four different parts. Kuch subordinates honge jo aapse bilkul baat nahi karenge. They're very shy and they don't want to talk to you. They just do their work and go back home. Second one is benevolent authoritative. Kuch subordinates honge jo thodi thodi baat kar lete hain, but not very free. There will be subordinates who will be sharing at a lot of times about things about their job, but not telling you certain aspects also. And then there will be some subordinates who will be completely free, who will be very close to you because they tell you everything and you tell them everything. Okay. And the third variable is extent to which immediate superior generally tries to get subordinates ideas and opinions and make constructive use of them. Yahan pe decision making ki baat ho rahi hai. Jab main, when I as a leader is taking decision, am I asking for, about your ideas and opinions or not? Exploitative, authoritative mein, bilkul puchega nahi. Seldom gets ideas and opinions of subordinates. Kabhi kabhi. In benevolent authoritative, sometimes gets ideas and opinions. In consultative, usually gets ideas and opinions. And in democratic, always gets ideas and opinions of subordinates. Hamesha main apne subordinates se poochta hu, bhai ye karna hai, tum batao. You tell me whether I should be doing this or not. That is democratic. Usually I ask them, but sometimes I take decisions on my own. That is consultative. Benevolent authoritative, I ask them sometimes, but majority of the times I take the decision myself. And in exploitative authoritative, I always take the decision myself. I never ask them. Okay, so this was Likert's four systems of management. I hope it's clear. Crazy Paulvina, whatever I'm speaking in Hindi, I'm saying the same thing in English, so don't worry about it. Don't think that I'm explaining some things in Hindi and I'm not repeating the same in English. Whatever I'm saying in Hindi, I'm repeating the same in English as well. Okay. The next one that we have is Hunari Yeager. I don't know how do you pronounce it. And Heckman, Four Styles of Management. Isne bhi, this is very similar to the Likert system. Inhone char styles diye management ke. Dictatorial, task-centered, autocratic, democratic, and laissez-faire group-centered manager. Dictatorial, 100% complete centralization of decision-making, complete dictatorship hoti hai. For example, North Korea, dictatorial management style follow hota hai. Autocratic managers order subordinates to accept decisions with little consultation. Bahut kam consultation hota hai. China, autocratic mein dal sakte hain. Theek hai? Because subordinates have to accept decisions, bahut kam consultation hota hai. Democratic, India ho sakta hai. Managers will ask for opinions from subordinates. High level of consultation and participation in decision making by subordinates. And the last one is, let's say India. And the last one is laissez-faire, 100% complete decentralization of decision making by the managers or total empowerment given to subordinates. Matlab, sare decisions jo ho rahe hain, wo PM na leke, the bureaucrats are taking all the decisions. Laissez-faire ho jayega. Let's say, Rahul Gandhi comes to power, then there will be laissez-faire. On a light note, this is just an example. It might not be true. Don't get offended. But laissez-faire, aise situation hogi where the leader is not taking decisions and there is complete decentralization of decision making. Last time I cracked a joke on Congress, some people got offended. Chalo. Himanshu is asking whether you'll be covering the course separately or not. This is just, these are just some sessions that I'm holding online on live on YouTube. Some topics that were left in the course. Otherwise, the entire course is completely completed. And of course, it's not completed on YouTube. There's a separate platform that you have to enroll in if you want to complete the entire course. Okay. So we are done with all these theories. Uske baad aate hain Tenenbaum and Smith leadership style pe. This is very important. Demonstrates the level of freedom that a manager chooses to give to their subordinates. Jitna freedom manager deta hai, to Tenenbaum and Smith level of freedom se yaad rakh sakte. You can remember it by this keyword level of freedom. The level of freedom that the superior decides to give to his subordinates along a continuum is what Tenenbaum and Smith leadership style talked about. Jitna zyada decision doge, utna leadership will be subordinate centered. The more freedom you give, the more subordinate centered is your leadership. The less freedom you give, the more manager centered leadership you have. Okay. So these are the different levels which are created. Tell, sell, suggest, consult, join, delegate, abdicate. Now let me explain this to you. Because in a lot of other situations, in a lot of other videos, you might have seen that people just explain tell kar diya, sell kar diya. What exactly do they mean? People don't talk about that. Let me talk about what exactly is telling, what exactly is selling. Okay. In telling style of leadership, there is minimum freedom, minimum freedom. So yeah, because we're talking about the freedom here. So there is minimum freedom in telling style and the leader tells the subordinate what is to be done. The leader tells subordinate what is to be done. And that is why it is given the word telling. Okay. What is to be done. The leader tells the subordinate what is to be done. That is why it is called as telling. The second one that we have is selling. So how exactly is selling different from telling? Selling means that the subordinates are given a chance to give their inputs, ultimate action by the leader. In selling, the manager makes decision and sells it to them. What is the meaning of selling it to the follower? But by selling, we mean that the followers have a chance to give their inputs to the leader whether this decision, this particular decision should be taken or not. So followers ko ek chance diya. In telling, you're not given even a single chance to the followers to tell you whether contribute and tell you, communicate whether this decision should be taken or not. You tell the follower that this is to be done. In selling, you are telling the follower what is to be done, but at the same time, you are asking the follower, bhai, ye karna chahiye, nahi karna chahiye, give me your inputs. So you're actually indirectly selling to the follower your idea because you're asking for the inputs now. The third one is suggest. Manager presents suggestions but invites questions. Subordinates can make suggestions and ask questions. अब देखो अगर इसको हम और अच्छे से समझना चाहें ना, the best example here is history of India. For people who have read the history of modern India, you would be very easily able to actually understand this because when the Britishers came, they actually used this leadership. Then they started using this kind of leadership. They gave some freedom. They started asking कि ये करना चाहिए या नहीं करना चाहिए. And then they were like, okay, whatever you tell is not important. Whatever communication is happening, whatever inputs you are giving, they are not important, but we are just asking you. Then comes suggestion. You have the right to ask questions. Then the leaders of India who were trying to get freedom, उनको थोड़ा थोड़ा राइट दिया कि भाई ठीक है, क्वेश्चन पूछ लो पार्लियामेंट में, यू कैन आस्क क्वेश्चंस, यू कैन गिव द योर सजेशंस. सो दैट वाज अ सजेस्ट पॉलिसी वेयर मोर फ्रीडम वाज गिवन. देन वी हैव द कंसल्ट. द टीम इज कंसल्टेड एंड इनपुट्स आर गिवन वेटेज. यहां पे कंसल्टेशन चल रहा है. इन सजेशन यू गिव योर सजेशन, दैट्स इट. ओके, यू आस्क योर क्वेश्चन, दैट्स इट. बट इन कंसल्टेशन द लीडर कंसल्ट्स द फॉलोअर्स, कंसल्ट्स द एम्प्लॉइज बिफोर टेकिंग एनी डिसीजन. दैट इज कंसल्टेशन. Joining, managers act like a team member. In joining, managers are a part of the team now. So there is an entire team. Let's say there are 10 employees and one leader, one manager. So now he's acting like a team member himself and not as a class apart from the employees. That is joining. Delegation, manager delegates activities and trusts the team. अब टीम मेंबर था मैं, सो वी आर डिसाइडिंग एवरीथिंग ऑन आवर ओन. डेलीगेशन में एक और स्टेप चला गया. आई एम सिटिंग सेपरेटली इन माय कैबिन बट आई टेल यू कि यार तुम ले लो डिसीजन. यू टेक दिस डिसीजन. आई एम नॉट टेकिंग दिस डिसीजन. आई एम डेलीगेटिंग इट टू यू. दैट इज डेलीगेशन. एंड एब्डिकेशन इज कंप्लीट मैक्सिमम फ्रीडम, नो इन्वॉल्वमेंट इन द टास्क. आई हैव गिवन यू अ टास्क. डेलीगेशन इज टेम्परेरी. वेर अ टास्क कम्स टू मी, लेट्स से फोर टास्क कम टू मी, मेरे पास चार टास्क हैं करने के लिए. मैंने उसमें से दो आपको दे दिए, दो आज अपने पास रख लिया. गिव टू टू यू एंड आई कीप टू टास्क टू माई सेल्फ. दैट इज डेलीगेशन. एबडिकेशन इज वेर आई गिव ऑल दी फोर टास्क ऑन अ परमानेंट बेसिस. वट एवर टास्क आई रिसीव ऑन अ डेली बेसिस, दे आर ऑटोमेटिकली गिवन टू यू. दैट इज अ मोर लॉन्ग टर्म अप्रोच एंड दैट्स वाई इट्स कॉल्ड एबडिकेशन. कंप्लीट फ्रीडम एंड नो इन्वॉल्वमेंट ऑफ द लीडर इन द टास्क. ओके. सेलिंग मीन्स कन्विंसिंग फॉलोअर. यू आर इनडायरेक्टली कन्विंसिंग फॉलोअर. But you are basically what you're doing is you're giving them a chance to give their inputs. आपने उनको बताया कि यार ये करना चाहते हैं. Do you have any suggestion? Okay, I ask you. Okay, I want to come live at and this often I do this very often. I ask the students on Telegram. Okay, I want to start a series. I've already decided, let's say a time at 8 a.m. and I ask them, I want to start a series and the time that I'm thinking about is 8 a.m. Are you fine with it? If students say, yes, sir, yes, sir, yes, sir, we are fine with it, then we go ahead. If a lot of students say, no, sir, we are not fine with it, I still might actually start it at 8 a.m. because there's no other slot available. Okay, there's no other slot where students are actually comfortable, or the teachers or the faculty that we have is actually comfortable in conducting those sessions. So we still might actually have them at 8 a.m. only. So in this case, I'm asking for your inputs. But your inputs might be important, might not be important. This is selling. Okay. Join. Join me. I become a part of the team. I become a part of the team. कई बार क्या होता है, when you are taking decisions, when you are actually solving problems in organization, आपके पास एक टीम होती है. एक लीडर तो होगा, वो अलग खड़ा रहेगा. एंड देन ही विल टेल एवरीबॉडी कि आपको ये करना है, आपको ये करना है, आपको यू नीड टू डू दिस, यू नीड टू डू दिस, दिस इज योर टास्क. To identify the task, and another leader would be who would sit with the entire team and identify how this problem should be solved. And they'll consult and they'll come to a common solution, and then they will solve the problem as a team. Okay, this is joining. Yes, already made decision, still trying to give options. यार काफी बड़ा चार्ट है. आई थिंक इट्स वेरी मच विजिबल. नहीं दिख रहा है तो मैं बता रहा हूँ सब कुछ. आई एम टेलिंग यू एवरीथिंग, डोंट वरी अबाउट दैट. ओके, द नेक्स्ट वन दैट वी हैव, आई थिंक वी आर लेफ्ट विद ओनली टू नाउ. आई I'm sure you must be tired. So we're done with liquor, we're done with four styles of management, we're done with Tenenbaum and Schmidt. We're left with three: Gordon Allport, John Adair's action-centered theory, and 10 fatal leadership flaws. These are very interesting. Bahut interesting sa maza aayega. Allport trait theory. Trait theory kya kehti hai? Let's understand that. Very simple. Trait theory ne kya bola? Gordon Allport ne kya bola? Unhone, he identified a lot of personality traits and then he grouped them into three kinds of traits that make a leader, make a person a leader. Cardinal traits, central traits and secondary traits. Ye traits hote hain jo batate hain ki ek aadmi leader kaisa hai, leader hai ya nahi hai. Theek hai na? What are the traits that exist in a person which create one person's personality and help us identify whether a person is a potential leader or not. Cardinal trait. Traits that dominates an individual's whole life. Calling God the father of the nation, calling a selfless person Christ-like. Kisi ek insaan ko Christ-like bolna because he is very selfless. Kisi ek aadmi ko, Mahatma Gandhi ko father of the nation bolna because of his central work in his entire life. That is a cardinal trait. To ek central theme create ho jata hai ek aadmi ka. That is called as a cardinal trait. Cardinal trait mera ho sakta hai at the end of 50 or 60 years if I'm alive, I might be called a teacher. That will be a cardinal trait. I might be called a person that made finance easy, made management easy. It might happen, it might not happen. Chances are very less. That might be a cardinal trait. Your, if let's say you're working in a bank, at the end of 40 years, you might be given a tag of the person who transformed the banking industry in India. That will be a cardinal trait. Okay. That a trait that dominates an individual's whole life, jiske piche aap kaam karte ho, jiske basis pe aapko define kiya jata hai, something that you work in your entire life and something that defines you is called as cardinal trait. Then you have central trait. You have a lot of central traits. Aap intelligent ho, you can be intelligent and at the same time you can be shy. You can be caring at the same time you can be cool. So these are traits that are used to describe a person when you go somewhere outside in a social setting or a professional setting. Okay. Bahut sare traits hote hain aise, which are meant to define you, your parts of personality which help other people understand you. These are central traits. And then you have secondary traits which are temporary in nature. So this is the biggest set of traits. Then you have central traits which are which can be multiple in nature, in number as well. And then there are secondary traits which are secondary in nature. Let's say in some situations I might be very shy, in some situations I might be very cool. Okay, let's say bahut sare logo ko stage fear hota hai, so although they are very comfortable in talking with their friends, when they reach out onto the stage they have a lot of stage fear. They experience anxiety and impatience, so that is a secondary trait. Kuch logo ko hota hai line mein khade hone ki aadat nahi hoti, they feel impatient when they're standing in a line. Some people get anxious when they're asked questions. So traits which show in a specific set of situations and then they fade away are secondary traits. So Gordon Allport ne bola ki ye trait theory hai, ye teen traits hain, in traits ke basis pe aap identify kar sakte ho kaun kaisa leader hai. That's all that he said. Okay. Yes, Pratik, nature of a person, basically personality traits that help you define another person, these are central traits. Okay. The next one that we have is John Adair's action-centered theory. Inhone zyada practical or simple angle liya by describing what leaders must do and actions they need to take. So the actions that they need to take and decisions that they need to make define a leader. Achieve the task, build the team, develop the individual. Teen actions leader ko lene hote hain. Every leader is required to take three actions, three decisions, and based upon these three decisions, you define or identify who is a good leader and who is a bad leader. Achieve the task, build the team, develop the individual. These three actions are required. And then he also explained why these three circles overlap. Because in order to achieve the task, you need a team. Because one person cannot do the task alone. So if task pura karna hai, you need the team. If the team needs are not met, the task will suffer. Okay. If the team needs development of the individuals in the team is not met, then the task will suffer. If the individual's needs are not met, the team will suffer. and performance of the task will be unfair. Because all these, according to John Adair, are connected with each other. If you want to achieve the task, you need to create a team. If you need to create a team, you need to develop the individuals. If you want to develop the individuals, you need to achieve the task and you need to create a team. Okay. What are the managerial responsibilities? So what he did was, he first of all took a practical approach and said that the manager or the leader is required to do these three things. Action oriented hai ye. That's why it's called action centered theory. उन्होंने personality वगैरह की बात नहीं करी leader की. उन्होंने बोला leader को ये तीन काम करने हैं. Leader is required to do these three things. Achieve the task, build the team, develop the individual. So there are some responsibilities of manager. There are some responsibilities of the manager with respect to the group. There are some responsibilities of the manager with respect to the individual. So manager की responsibility है towards the task, towards the team, towards the individual. I hope that's clear. And what are these responsibilities? They are very simple. Identify aims and visions of the group, purpose and direction. Identify resources, people, processes, systems and tools which are required. So what are the responsibilities with respect to the task? Achhe log identify karo. Identify what needs to be done, how it is to be done, what is the process, what are the tools that should be used. I create the plan to achieve the task. Identify and create a plan. All these are responsibilities towards the task. What are the responsibilities towards the group? Communicate standards of performance and behavior with the group. Tell the group, tell the team what is to be done, how it is to be done. Take care of the group. Develop their soft skill and hard skills. Okay. Resolve conflicts which arise in the organization at the team level. Develop team working. Teach them how do they actually get the work done in teams. You might have seen in colleges when you were made to work in groups, you often felt that people kept fighting among these groups. One person is doing a lot, another person is not doing anything. There's a third person who's trying to dodge these two situations. So team working becomes a little difficult. Teen char log hi ek saath kaam nahi kar sakte. Even 3-4 people were not able to work together in colleges in group decision or group exercises. So developing team working aptitude among the team, among the group, is also a responsibility of the manager. Similarly, responsibilities towards individuals. Individuals might have some specific problems, some personality issues, let's say financial problems, psychological problems. Understanding those and resolving them, those are responsibilities. Okay, last pe aate hain. I know everybody's tired. It's been a very long session, but I wanted to cover this. Last time, hamara 10 fatal leadership flaws, very important. Zenger Folkman ne kya kiya? What he did was, instead of telling us what are the leadership traits that are required, he told us what are the flaws in leadership. And if you are free of these 10 fatal leadership flaws, then you are a good leader. So inhone, instead of touching his or holding his ear like this, he held his ear like this. Okay. So he said that normally people are saying that, okay, these are the traits that are required to, call a person a good leader. He said, these are the traits that are required, but these are the traits that are not required. So let me answer them. If these non-required traits are not available, not present in a person, then he will, of course, be a good leader. Okay. So he went, otherwise he went in a different direction, and that was very interesting. So these fatal flaws create a negative halo effect and must be removed, according to Zenger Folkman. Kya hai ye? What are these 10 leadership flaws? Not inspiring due to lack of energy and enthusiasm. If you are a leader or claiming to be a leader, but if you yourself don't have energy and enthusiasm, I am claiming to be a teacher, I want to be a leader here. If I myself am not energetic and enthusiastic about what I'm teaching you, how will you be following me? Not possible. So that is number one. Accepting mediocre performance. Agar main accept karne lagunga ki aap na padho to bhi chalega, then how will I be a good leader? How will I be a good teacher? Okay, I will not be. So accepting mediocre performance is something that a leader cannot have. Lack of clear vision and direction. If I don't give you a good direction, if I myself does not have a clear vision and direction, the vision here is helping you clear these examinations. That is the direction that I'm working towards. If I myself am not clear, how will I be a good leader? So I should have a clear vision and direction. Loss of trust. If I don't trust you, you will not be able to trust me. And then the decision or the vision that we have will not be the sorry vision and the direction that we have defined, that I have defined for both of us, will not be achieved. Okay, not a collaborative team player. If I am not a collaborative team player, then I will not be able to help you work in a team. Agar main collaborate nahi kar sakta aapke saath, you will not be able to collaborate with other people around you. If not, I am not able to collaborate and work as a team with you, you will not be able to work as a team with other people around you. Okay. Not a good role model, failure to walk the talk. If I'm not good with whatever I am teaching you, how can I inspire you to study? Okay. This happens a lot on in a lot of online classes. The teachers are teaching, but they're not aware about what exactly are they teaching. So they fail to be good role models. They're not able to walk the talk. Okay. When questions are asked, they're not able to answer those questions. No self-development and learning from mistakes. If I don't focus on self-development, if I think that whatever I'm doing is correct, I'm not making any mistakes, then I do not inspire confidence. There might be times when I also make mistakes. I should be able to develop based upon those mistakes, identify and accept those mistakes, develop based upon those mistakes, and try not to make those mistakes again. Okay. Lacking interpersonal skills. Baat nahi kar sakta. If I cannot talk to you, if I'm not able to understand your problems and talk at a very sensitive level with you, then I will not be a good leader. Resistance to new ideas, very important. If I feel ki yaar purane tarike se hi padhate hain, let's not use examples, let's just tell you what are the keywords, I will not be a good teacher because I'm resistant to new ideas of teaching. I'm resistant to teaching through talking with the students rather than just telling them what is to be done and what are the keywords. And the next one is focus is on self, not the development of others. If I keep focusing on myself and my growth, I will be a failure because my development and my growth is dependent upon your development and your growth. If you don't develop, if you don't grow, if you're not successful, I will not be successful. It's as clear as that. Okay. I hope it's very, very clear. We have discussed all the miscellaneous theories, new theories of leadership today. It took us 1.5 hours, but it's fine. Very good session. A lot of you kept sitting here. In case you left in the middle, no problem. You can come back and have a look at the session yet again. Okay. I hope you liked the session. If you did, do not forget to subscribe to the channel. Press the bell icon so that you keep getting notifications about these beautiful sessions that we are creating in order to identify this time that we have where we are not doing anything else, just studying for the time. Okay. All the very best, guys. Take care. Have a nice day.